HART is getting ready for a big project along Dillingham Boulevard that'll affect businesses, residents, and drivers. Bryce Moore reports.
The $500 million project covers about a mile and a half stretch of Dillingham Boulevard from Kamehameha Highway to Ka'a'ahi Street. Work will begin the weekend following Thanksgiving. HART and NAN Inc. held a virtual community meeting Thursday.
We will start a dedicated traffic control that will be up 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. We will close the Mackay lanes heading eastbound on Dillingham. This will lead a minimum of one traffic lane open, and which will be maintained in each direction.
The project is expected to wrap up in January 2026, and area businesses will be notified ahead of when work fronts their driveways. But since sewer, gas, and electrical lines are just some of what's being moved, officials say everyone should be prepared.
The probability is that we'll be working in front of every business for the duration of the project, because it has to do with the multiple utilities that are being relocated.
Left turns from Dillingham won't be allowed when the project starts, and left turns from cross streets onto Dillingham will also be restricted. Work will be 24/7 except for intersections, and NAN says they'll have monitors to keep track of the noise at night.
However, should you have any noise concerns, please call the 24-hour project hotline at 808-566-2299.
The president of Soderholm Bus and Mobility is just one affected business owner. She has concerns. Apart from losing revenue, she says virtual meetings at noon aren't accessible to everyone.
If they were at work, what are they going to do? They're going to go in and tell their boss, hey boss, I'm going to take an hour off right now to attend this meeting about HART.
Officials say they're just getting the project running and are open to in-person meetings in the future. For now, the next community meeting is scheduled virtually on November 23rd at noon. We'll have more information on the relocation project on our website, khon2.com. Bryce Moore, KHON2 News, working for Hawaii.